Good morning. Today is November 18th. I am on my break while I'm at work, taking a little walk. I try to take a walk twice a day while I'm at work. I go down these stairs here, and then I go up the stairs to try to get in some incline. You know, get my calves and heartbeat up a little bit. There was somebody over there. Do you see her? She's right there. Embarrassed talking to myself on video. Like, I'm not embarrassed to talk to the video camera, but I'm embarrassed when there's other people around and they can hear me talking to myself. See, now I'm out of breath. I'm not feeling good today. I've been feeling really crummy since last night, and I really wasn't sure what it was. I thought it had something to do with my psychological stuff going on with my husband and all the feelings that I'm going through. And I woke up this morning not feeling very good at all either. But my coworker just put her hand on my back right now, and she says I have a fever. So if I have a fever, that's actually good news. That means psychologically I'm not feeling crummy. Like, I just felt achy and just different all over. I couldn't put my finger on it. I didn't really feel like I had a fever. I really wasn't sure what it was. I really thought that I was going through torment or something. I thought I was torturing myself, and I was trying to get myself in a headspace where I felt good and I felt fine. And I did feel emotionally, I felt fine. I wasn't crying, I wasn't freaking out, but I thought that my body was going through torment. Like, it just didn't feel good. It just was really weird how crummy it felt, and I thought it had to do with my thoughts and what I was thinking. And maybe it does. Maybe it is all related. Maybe it is because of what I'm tossing with back and forth. And here's what I'm tossing with back and forth, in case I'm not being very clear. Habitually, typically, when my husband's upset with me, it bothers me to my core, and I do everything I can to get him to understand me, and I get to explain my side of things, and I try to get him to see where he's wrong, and I try to get him to see what he needs to improve on, or what is maybe the reason why he's feeling this way. And because I'm not doing that, but wanting to do that, like, that's my knee-jerk reaction, that's my habitual go-to solution. Because I'm not doing it, it's kind of just that little guy on the shoulder just egging at me that I need to fix this for my husband. I need to figure it out for him. But it's so rewarding to not fix it for him and just let him struggle on his own, like watching a baby walk for the first time. It's like exciting to see my husband push through it without me running over and saving him. It's hard, it's difficult. I don't like watching my husband fall and stumble and be angry and be upset and not speak to me and just being cold and distant. Like, he didn't kiss me goodbye this morning. He didn't really, he wasn't really kind to me last night. He wasn't warm at all. He was kind of cold and distant, and I get it. I really do. He's angry with me, and he doesn't think I'm there for him, and he thinks it's all my fault while he's feeling what he's feeling. I used to hold him responsible for my feelings too. I did. And I'm learning not to hold him responsible for my feelings, so he needs to learn that too. The second thing that I thought was interesting and I wanted to mention was yesterday my finger was hurting really bad with my ring finger on it, my rings on it, on my ring finger. And so I took off my rings to allow my skin and my finger to relax. And I can't get my rings back on. My fingers are so fat and swollen, and like I've gained some weight. I think it's water weight and stress and stuff. But it's just interesting because I'm going through this with my husband. It's symbolic to me that I can't wear my ring right now. Just like I can't save him right now. It's just interesting.